everyone. Today we will start the subject EBS 1 of grade 5 and the chapter number 4 is environmental balance. As we are living in environmental, there should be balance. So we are the form to make a balance in the environment. Let us start with the point biodiversity. What is biodiversity? The variety in all the living things belonging to a particular area. We are living in environment, we have many different kind of things in environment. So there are variation in the environment and this variation is known as biodiversity. Next is scientist observation. Scientists, they research, they observe many things. Then after they perform a particular thing and after their research, they consider as a biodiversity. Time and season. As scientists observe everything, so they use time, means daytime also and night time also. They perform their research or observation in both the time and in every season. We have different kind of season, that is summer season, rainy season, winter season. So in all season they observe everything which happens in a biodiversity, in an environment. So it is a long period of time for scientists to observe everything. Next is environment. So in environment we have living and non-living thing. So what is living thing? Living thing means the thing which is alive, and non-living thing means the thing which is not alive. For example, human beings, plants, animals are considered as living thing, and in non-living thing we have air, water, sunlight, soil, etc. These are all non-living thing. Dependent and interaction. These both living and non-living thing, they depend on each other and they interact with each other. They are interrelated to each other. Next is food chain. What is food chain? See, we are living thing. For growth, we need a food. So that food, how perform their things or how this food chain occur, we will discuss this. Living thing depend upon each other for food and feed. Means for food or feeding to own self, we are dependent on each other. Living thing depend on another living thing. For example, human beings depend on animal and plants. Animal depend on plants and other animals. So this is the interdependent on each other. In nature, there are different types of food chain. If anyone connection is lost in a food chain, then it's come to an end. So in nature, in our environment, for feeding or for food, so we are depend on each other. We have different kind of food chain. For example, a grasshopper eat grass and a sparrow eat grasshopper. This is known as food chain. For example, grasshopper depend on grass and a sparrow depend on grasshopper. If this chain split or break down or separate to each other, so that means if food chain come to an end, we cannot say that this is a food chain. Now the next is food web. Food web means most of the living things are depend on each other. When different food chains are combined together, they form a food web. Different kind of food chain, if they combine together to each other, for example, a snake eat rat also and a snake eat earthworm also. So one animal, but they eat both the animals. So this is known as food web. The food chain which is combined together, it is known as food web. Next is plants. Plant is also a living thing. Plants form the main support. As I told you that plant is very important in our environment and it is the main support for food chain also and for other living things also. Every living thing get its food from the surrounding environment. Means we are living thing and we get our food from our surrounding vegetables, fruits, animals can eat leaves, etc. Some animals consume plant materials. Some animals eat plant materials. That animal is known as herbivorous animal. Means that animal eats plants, leaves, etc. Plants prepare their own food. Plants make their own food with the help of sunlight, carbon dioxide, water, and the mineral which is present in the soil. Next is environmental balance. How we should be balanced an environment? Obtain its own food. We get food from environment. So it is the first point that we have to balance it by the food. Next, microorganisms in the soil, decomposition and nutritive substances like fertilizer for plants. See, microorganism in the soil, microorganism present, and that microorganism give nutrition to the soil, and that soil pass that nutrition to the plants. So it is known as environmental balance. Decomposition. Decomposition means the dead part of an animal or any plant. So this mixed with the soil and that nutrition give plant a balanced environment or a balanced nutrition to the plant. Next is animals, plants, soil growth. Animal consume plants. Plants get nutrition soil and that soil growth the plant. Because of water cycle, all the living things get water. Means the continuation of water cycle, that is evaporation, condensation, precipitation. So this continuous water cycle gives all the nutrition or water to the environment. And for balancing the environment, we need that water cycle should be continued. Next, oxygen carbon dioxide cycle. This is very important gases. Animal use oxygen for breathing. See, for breathing, animal use oxygen means for inhaling, they use oxygen. Give out carbon dioxide. Give out carbon dioxide means they exhale carbon dioxide. Plant use carbon dioxide for preparation of food and give out oxygen. Here opposite, animal use oxygen for breathing, for inhaling, but plant use oxygen for exhaling. Animals use carbon dioxide for exhaling, but plant use carbon dioxide for preparation of food. So inhaling and exhaling is a part which is very important for breathing. Balance of both the gases. This both gases means oxygen and carbon dioxide. This should be balanced. If it is imbalanced, so it may harm to our environment. Next, interaction between living and non-living thing. As we live in environment, so we have to interact with each other. All living thing and non-living thing, they should interact with each other. Interaction continuously in nature. Because we are in nature, so continuously we have to interact with each other. Maintain the food chain. This food chain is very important for all living and non-living thing or for balancing the environment. So we have to maintain this food chain. Due to human interference, their cycle may break down and can cause an environmental imbalance. If the human being interfere this food chain or this environment, so it may be loss of or it may cause environmental imbalance. So as a human being, we have to take this part very importantly for maintaining environmental balance.